to show you our ACR DC circuit breaker. Order code is 46532. So this is the trainer key. Here, this is the DC circuit breaker circuit. We have used here two ACR. This is ACR 1 and ACR 2. This is the capacitor bank. There are five different types of capacitor are here. And this is RL bank. Sorry, RL load bank. We can see there are different type of resistor are here. This is, there are two UJT. This circuit will be used to observe the over current and over voltage trip condition. User manual and patch codes are included with this kit. Our first experiment is to study ACR turn off action under varying loads. So for this we are going to use this circuit here. So first we are going to connect C1 to 1 microfarad. We can take any value of this. So first I am taking 1 microfarad and we will connect this to here. Now again from this terminal we will connect the RL load bank. Now we will connect P1 and P and G1 and G2. So here this is G1 and G2. Now also we will connect 300E RL load to the RL load section of the circuit here. Now we need to give external DC power supply 30 volt 2 ampere. So connect the positive terminal here with the positive terminal of the power supply and connect the negative terminal of this to the negative terminal of the power supply and turn on the power supply. We can see it is giving 30 volt. Now we will turn on this ACR 2 by pressing the start button, and we can see as the ACR 2 is turned on, the LED is also glowing. Now what happens is when we push this button, push the start button, ACR 2 is turned on and delivers powers to the load bank. Now this capacitor C1 gets charged to the load voltage through R2 through this resistor. Now this side of the capacitor is positive voltage and this side is the negative voltage. Now what we will do is we will press this stop button to start ACR 1. So as we we also need to connect G4 and G3. Now we need to press this stop button to start ACR1. As we press this button, ACR1 is turned on, and what happens is when this ACR1 is turned on, the positive terminal of this capacitor gets connected to the cathode of ACR2, and as it gets connected to the cathode of ACR2, it turns the ACR2 in reverse bias, and as the ACR2 becomes reverse bias, it turns off and the LED is also turned off. So by pressing the switch start, by pressing this start button, we are turning on the ACR2, and in turn the diode is turned on. And when we are pressing stop button, we turn on the ACR1 and ACR1 turns off the ACR2. So this was our experiment to turn off action under varying loads. So we can again simply do this experiments by changing the capacitor and resistor. Again turn on ACR2, the LED is turned on indicating that ACR2 is conducting, and press this button, then ACR1 is turned on and it turns off the ACR2. So you can perform this experiments with different types of capacitor and different types of load. Our Our next experiment is to study DC over voltage and DC over current trip action. So for this, we are going to build this circuit here. So first, we will connect the RL load to the RL load bank. So I am taking again 300 ohm. Now, we will connect this end of the capacitor to here and we will take 0.22 microfarad and connect the capacitor C1 to this terminal. Again we will take another capacitor 0.1 microfarad and we will connect it again to the capacitor C1. Now we will connect G1 and G2. Next, we will connect P1 to P3. Now we will connect P to P2, P with P2, and we will connect G to G3. G to G3. Now keep this both potentiometer at minimum position and connect the external DC power supply. Also we need to connect this terminal on the load bank here. The negative terminal of the C1, that is here. Now through this experiment we will see the automatic triggering of SCR1. So first turn on the power supply and press the start button to turn on the SCR2. Now as in the previous experiment, as we have seen that pressing this button will turn off the LED. We are pressing this button and the LED is not turned off. Now what we will do is with the help of this potentiometer, we will turn on the SCR1 automatically and the diode will turn off. So this potentiometer is for over voltage and this potentiometer is for over current. Now slowly increase the value till it reach the respective UJT peak point voltage. We can see as this voltage as R6 has reached the respective UJT peak point voltage, it automatically turns on the SCR1 and SCR2 turned off. Similarly, we can do the same experiment for overcurrent. So this is the overcurrent, this is for overcurrent. So turn on the SCR2. Now increase the potentiometer clockwise and we can see as it reaches the peak point voltage, the SCR2 automatically turns off. As SCR1 is turned off, we didn't need to press this button to turn on the SCR1.